Hello and welcome to the Ambassador Vlogs, and the time has finally come. The time for a new vinyl roof. Now, despite my best efforts to hide it, if you've watched any of this series, you've seen that the original vinyl roof on this car is past its prime. So today, I am beginning the process of getting a new vinyl roof put on, which involves several steps. First off, we're going to pay a visit to my friend, Ross Miller, who is an expert on post-war Studebakers and Packards. Now, why am I taking an AMC to a Studebaker Packard expert? Well, Ross was kind enough to offer his services to help me strip the old vinyl, sand away the residue, and then paint the roof to prevent the spread of any rust that could be lurking underneath. Oh, what do we have here? An old Buick. No, that's a DeSoto. Check that out. Huh. Now, despite the very solid condition of this car overall, I could see a few specks of rust poking through the worn-out areas in the vinyl, and until we peel it all off, I really won't know how bad it is. So just to play it safe, we're going to strip it all off, get it sanded down, painted, and then that way there's a watertight seal and we don't have some nightmare where the new roof goes on and then rust starts to form underneath it. And since this paint will be hidden underneath the vinyl, hopefully for eternity, we don't have to do anything fancy, we just have to get nice even coverage. Before the work begins, some background on my friend Ross. He's a Studebaker and Packard enthusiast with a penchant for turning cars into pickup trucks. When he finds an old model that's not worth restoring, he fabricates a bed, tailgate, and rear window, and turns it into a truck. The end result are pickups that look almost like they rolled out of the factory that way. Ross also built himself a Packard hot rod, using spare parts, including a Packard automatic transmission and a Packard straight 8 engine. No Chevy 350 here. Even though he's not an AMC owner, I figured anybody who loves old unusual cars like this would treat my car right. The vinyl peeled away easily at first, leaving behind a residue that looked eerily like rust, but was mostly just 45-year-old adhesive. It was very satisfying to grab a loose edge and tear off a big strip. But removing the chrome windshield trim proved somewhat trickier. A series of clips hold the trim against the body, and this banana-shaped tool helps unclip it. However, you can't actually see the clips when they're under the trim, so it took me a few minutes to figure things out. It also didn't help that we were working in direct sunlight on a 95-degree day.
Oh, it's hot!
And because some designer thought it was a good idea to put a teeny piece of vinyl on the rear door, we carefully removed the trim around that, too. Finally, all of the old vinyl was gone. Having heard horror stories about what lurks under these roofs, I was thrilled to only see some very minor rust. 2 days later, I came back and found this. I have to admit, the Ambassador looks good with a smooth gray roof. You wouldn't think the two colors would go together. However, I couldn't leave it like this.
I was understandably nervous about ordering new vinyl for this car because it's not like there's millions of people restoring AMC Ambassadors. So the aftermarket support for matching materials is somewhat limited. However, a friend of mine recommended SMS Auto Fabrics, and sure enough, they were able to match the grain and color perfectly, and they even sent me a sample to confirm it. Now, despite being somewhat unfriendly and taking longer than predicted to finally get the top to me, it eventually did arrive.
What's up, guys and girls on the internet? It's time for another unboxing and reaction video from AutoMoments. Let's see what's in that box. It is a brown vinyl roof for a 1972 AMC Ambassador. Look at that grain. Oh, man. And it has pre-stitched seams, so you don't have to sew anything. Don't forget to support this channel, like, rate, comment, and subscribe. Hit the bell. Whoa! Thanks for watching AutoMoments.
In all seriousness, after inspecting the material and finding no defects, I couldn't wait to see it go on the car.
And so now, with the trim removed, the rust taken care of, the steel painted, and the top finally having arrived, it's time to take this car to an upholstery shop and get the vinyl put on.
On my friend Homer's recommendation, I went to a place called Johnny's Auto Upholstery, which ironically is run by a guy named Mike. Johnny died 40 years ago. Anyways, Mike said he hadn't done a new vinyl top in about 5 years, but back in the 80s, he did 2 or 3 a week. I wasn't able to film in the shop, but these photos show the progression. First, he taped everything off, applied the glue, put down the vinyl, and cut away a startling amount of excess material. But I guess it's always better to have too much than not enough. By 6 o'clock the same day, he was done. And remember our friendly little clips? Well, putting the chrome trim back on took significantly less work. I just set it down, snapped it into place, and then double-checked to see it was secure. And at last, my 1972 AMC Ambassador Brome had a new vinyl roof. It looks really, really good. The new one matches the original color, even though it looks slightly darker, only because the old one was so faded and worn out. The seams aren't in quite the same position as before, but only a true AMC fanatic would notice. And Mike used the excess material to replace the little pieces on the doors. All in all, it gives the Ambassador the distinguished look it deserves.
I know it doesn't make any logical sense, but I can't help but feel like this car drives just a little bit better ever since it got the new vinyl top. Maybe it's like when you get a fresh haircut and you have that little boost of confidence. After all these years of having a bald spot up top, the Ambassador finally has something to show off to other cars. And so to celebrate the occasion, I decided to take the Ambassador to its first big car show of the season. I drove all the way to Orwigsburg, Pennsylvania for the regular car reviews show. And I had a lot of fun there. There was some really bizarre stuff. Nowhere else would you see people so excited to see a mint condition Ford Granada with a Ronald McDonald bumper sticker on the back. And I think that's what was really the great thing about the show is everybody else was just thrilled to see all these weird and wonderful cars all in one spot. I wound up parking next to a Pontiac Aztec, which included the optional tent that hangs off the rear hatch. And while the Aztec got most of the attention, there were a handful of people who stopped by to look at the Ambassador. Some of them had no idea what it was, so of course I got to explain all about AMC. As for the handful who did know what it was, they were very excited to see an Ambassador in the wild. And one person even asked, "What did you do to keep the vinyl top so nice?" And I said, "Well, I didn't do much, it's brand new." But you can bet after all that work, I'm gonna take good care of it for sure. And I know I'm not the fastest or the most capable when it comes to working on car stuff, so I'm very thankful for all the people along the way who helped me out with this, including Ross Miller, and of course Mike at Johnny's Auto Upholstery. There's just a lot of good people who have helped me with this car the whole way along. And when I first got this car, two of the big problem areas were the top and the transmission. And now that they're both taken care of, I feel like I can really enjoy it. And of course, I have more videos planned for Auto Moments, so stay tuned for those. But that actually brings up something I wanted to talk about. Recently, I've noticed a lot of comments that say things like, "Oh, you have such a great channel, why don't you have more subscribers?" Or, "Oh, I love this video so much, how come it doesn't have more views?" And I really don't know the answer to that, but I know the solution to that is to have more people like and share my videos. And so I want to ask viewers like you to help me grow this channel by sharing these videos with your friends. When I started making car videos almost 10 years ago now, I had no idea that they'd become so popular. But I seem to have struck a chord with this weird little corner of YouTube where people love these under-recognized cars. And to all of you who've been with Auto Moments since the beginning, or you know, even before it was called Auto Moments, back when it was called The Car Meet, I can't thank you enough. So with that, I guess I better go get to work on more videos. But until next time, thanks for watching.